There are defaults that are arranged just like our old black and white color filters. So, for example, if we were working on a landscape photo and we wanted to darken the sky and keep the clouds nice and bright, we might add a red filter. So, under our menu, we could go down to Red Filter, and it applies this preset. As you can see here, it's brightened the reds and darkened the blues. And in fact, there's a deep red filter, which they call High Contrast Red Filter, which accentuates that even more. So this is a great way to get creative effects with your black and white conversion, and you get complete control over those tones and how they're going to be converted into the final image. There's actually one more way in Photoshop that I'm going to show you how to convert an image from color to black and white, and it's actually a pretty useful and cool way to do it, but I'm not going to show you that one right now. For the moment, I'm just going to go ahead and close this image down, not save it, and I'm going to show you the other way that I convert images to black and white the most frequently, and that is from the start in Adobe Camera Raw. This program probably looks familiar to you. If not, it's because I've customized my colors to make it look a little bit more like Adobe Lightroom. This is Adobe Bridge, which all of you have if you have Photoshop. It is the file browser, and it's actually a lot more than a file browser. In fact, I pretty generally use it instead of Lightroom these days. You can import your files from the camera, and instead of using the develop module in Lightroom, you use Adobe Camera Raw, which I'm going to open now. I've selected this photo here and pressed the little aperture-looking icon, which opens the image in RAW. Okay, here we are. Let me see if I can fit this into the screen. Doesn't want to resize any smaller than that, so that's good enough for now. So here we have a picture of some sunflower-looking things. Obviously, this was taken in the Pawnee grasslands in Colorado. And it's kind of an interesting color picture, but I think it also could be an interesting black and white. So, how do you use Adobe Camera Raw to convert to black and white? Well, it's pretty simple. You go over to your HSL window here, and you click Convert to Grayscale. And what you have below is very much like the black and white layer adjustment layer that we saw in Photoshop. The only difference here is that it actually has more options. You can work with oranges, not just reds and yellows. You can work with aquas and purples. So suppose these petals, which were kind of orange, suppose I wanted to brighten up these orange petals. Well, I would just move up my orange slider, or the yellow slider, or both. And now I have a really bright, contrasty bloom against these dark clouds. Or if I wanted to darken those clouds, which were sort of purplish blue, there I can move my blues down and the aquas and the purples, and that darkens it up further. And of course, once I'm done, I just click Open Image, and that will open it up in Photoshop, or I can click Done, and that'll take me back to Bridge, but it will apply the changes. And of course, any time that I want to get back to my color image, all I have to do is open up the photo in Camera Raw again and undo the convert to grayscale, and all of that data is still there. This is a completely non-destructive way to work. Now I'm actually going to convert this to gray. As you can see, when I undid this and redid it, it threw away the changes that I made, so that's something you want to be careful about. I'm going to go ahead and brighten up those oranges and yellows again. So I've got some nice contrast in the background. I guess there's no need to worry about getting this perfect here for now. And I'm going to open up this image so that I can show you the next step. Alright, I've opened this image in Photoshop, as you can see, but I've also opened it as a color image, and that's because I want to show you the one final black and white conversion method that I mentioned previously. The reason that I'm doing it this way is that I don't usually actually use it as a black and white conversion method. I use it to tone black and white images, but since it does do black and white conversion, let me show you that first with this color image. This is an adjustment layer. I'm going to go down to my adjustment layer menu and select gradient map. And as you can see, it is now a black and white image. What's happened here is that the gradient map adjustment layer has mapped my foreground color, which is black, onto the darkest tones in the image, and my background color, which is white, onto the lightest tones. So I get a just normal black and white image. But if I had had a different foreground color set, if this were blue, for example, then this wouldn't be a black and white image, it would be a blue and white image. And of course, these sorts of changes can be made after the fact, and I'll show you that in just a moment. But before I do that, first of all, take a look at the difference between our Adobe Raw Camera Raw conversion, nice and contrasty, versus the one that we just did with the gradient map, which is kind of flat looking. Much better to do that in Camera Raw to begin with. But as a toning exercise, let's go ahead and take a look at what we can do here in the adjustment layer. I'm going to click on this little gradient, and as you can see, I can choose any of a variety of different gradient patterns, and it can do some really bizarre things to the image. But going back to something a little more normal, I can click on this black in my image and change that color to something useful. Like, suppose I want to go for a more warm, something like a selenium, like a sepia tone picture. I can just select kind of a dark brownish color. And as you can see, that tones my image, this sort of nice warm variant of a black and white, which is actually really pretty. Now, what will happen if I try to go over and do this to my Camera Raw converted image? Well, first of all, let me create the gradient map. But you can see something's a little odd to begin with. All of these vibrance, hue saturation, all of these sort of color-related filters or adjustment layers are not available. Gradient map is, but when I try to choose a different color, nothing's available. It's still grayscale. And of course, the reason for that is that this image, let's see here, if we look at the channels, all this has is a grayscale channel. There's no place for color tones to be. So if I want to do toning on this, Then I have to go up to image mode and change this to RGB color. I will actually cancel that. I've got my gradient map that I'm going to get rid of first. Then convert it to RGB color. And now, when I go in and put my gradient map in, it'll actually work. And I can change this background color to whatever bizarre color I feel like. There we go. Kind of a crazy blue. And so this can be a really beautiful way to alter a photo, to change the atmosphere, to change the emotion conveyed. But you can also use it with a set of photos. And even if they are not taken in the same place, if they're taken at different times, of different subjects, if you tone them all the same way, it creates a kind of cohesion. So that's another useful way to use toning like this. There are a couple of different other ways to tone photos, and I will cover those in more detail later, but this is a useful little one, so I'm glad we've got it in.